Hello everyone, I hope all of you are fine. My name is Shubham and today we'll be continuing with the next topic, that is the practical applications of heating effects of current. So it is a purely theoretical topic and there are two or three questions in your NCERT which we'll be discussing in the next video of course. So let's try to read it and understand what it says. The generation of heat in a conductor is an inevitable consequence. Inevitable consequence means it is something which cannot be stopped. It has to happen. So in many cases it is undesirable as it converts useful electrical energy into heat. In some of the appliances it may not be desirable since it is converting the given amount of energy into heat. Means we are applying the electricity or we are giving the electrical energy so that a particular electrical appliance could work. But the electrical appliance has some amount of energy lost which is being converted into heat, so that is why it is highly undesirable in some cases. In electrical circuits, the unavoidable heating can increase the temperature of components and alter their properties. Alter means change, means when the temperature of that particular appliance has risen, so it has to change its properties, so that is why also it is undesirable. However, the heating effect of electric current has some many useful applications. Now the useful applications could be our electric iron, could be our electric kettle, could be our electric toaster. Means these are the devices which works on the concept of Joule's law of heating. I hope you remember the concept of Joule's law of heating, what we discussed in the previous videos. If you still haven't watched those videos, kindly go and watch them so you will get a better idea of what Joule's law of heating is. So these are the electrical appliances on which are based on the Joule's law of heating. The next part is electrical heating is also used to produce light, as in case of electric bulb. This we already know that we connect the bulb through the switch and the electrical energy runs through the bulb and then it is converted into light. So here the conversion of one type of energy into the other type of energy is there, so means heat is a byproduct of such sort of phenomenon. The filament must retain as much of the heat generated as possible so that it gets very hot and emits light. So whenever a particular substance or a particular thing gets very hot, it starts emitting light. So this is what happens in the filament of a bulb. It must not melt. Ye melt nahi hona chahiye, because if it would melt, it will not be able to capture that much amount of heat and thereby we won't be able to get light from it. So these are the few examples. Tungsten is such a material for which it is used for making bulb filaments. You can read through. The filament should be thermally isolated as much as possible with using insulating support, etc. What is the meaning of this thermal isolation? It means the heat should not be coming out from that particular filament. The filament should have the property of retaining the heat so that it can later on glow. Okay, I hope you are getting. The bulbs are usually filled with chemically inactive nitrogen. This you already know, that the argon and nitrogen gases are being filled in the bulb to prolong the life of the filament so that the filament could work for longer periods. So most of the power consumed by the filament appears as heat, but a part of it is form of light. Part of it form is the light radiated. So this is purely a theoretical topic. You can read as well. I am giving you just few points for this. Another common application of Joule's law of heating is the fuse of electrical circuits. You all are seeing the fuse at your homes. It protects the circuits and appliances by stopping the flow of any unduly high current. So what fuse does is, for example, if high amount of current and tries to enter to your appliances, the fuse automatically cuts them. मतलब एक पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट से ज़्यादा करंट हमारे इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायंस में नहीं आ सकता, क्योंकि अगर वो आ गया, it means that electrical appliance would stop working. So fuse plays a role of a regulator, so called. A regulator fuse is a regulator. It is placed in series with the appropriate melting point. For example, aluminium, copper. These are the examples for the materials for which the fuse is used. If a current larger than the specified value flows to the circuit, this is what I was telling you, that किसी एक अमाउंट से अगर करंट ज़्यादा आ गया किसी सर्किट में, द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द फ्यूज वायर इंक्रीजेस, तो टेम्परेचर उसका बढ़ जाएगा. This melts the fuse wire and breaks the circuit. So this leads to the melting of fuse wire and thereby leading to automatically breakage of the circuit. So I hope you are getting what we are trying to suggest in this. The fuse wire is usually encased in the cartridge of porcelain and similar materials with other matter. So this is the material jiska fuse banta hai. The fuses are used for the purpose rated as this 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere. These are all known as the rating of fuse. Rating means the capacity of holding the current. This 1 ampere would be able to hold for 1 ampere amount of current, then 2 ampere, then 3 ampere, then 4 and then 5. For an electrical ion which consumes 1 kilowatt of energy, so this is a simple example by using the formula P is equal to V into I. So you can use this formula for calculating the value for current. Power would be 1 kilowatt. 1 kilowatt means 1000 watt. So value of P would be 1000 watt. And the voltage has also been given to us. That is 220. So when we apply power and voltage in this formula, we can calculate the value for current. So we can see that what amount of you can say current is being flowing in the circuit is 4.54 ampere of current is being flowing in the circuit. It means it has to be a fuse of 5 ampere, so that if we will use a fuse of less than 4 ampere or less than 4.5 ampere, this is 4.54. if we use a fuse less than 4.54, then it will melt again. So usse bada humne use karna, usse zyada quantity wala use karna. That is why we have been using this fuse of 5 ampere for the particular requirement of current. Theek hai? So we'll continue in the next video. Thank you.